Hello friend, this lecture is based on the classification of conglomerate. First of all, conglomerate is an rudaceous sedimentary rock which is composed of rounded pebbles, and its angular equivalent, that means the rock which is composed of angular fragments, is known as a breccia. This breccia is indicative of less transport of the pebbles, and on the other hand, this conglomerate is indicating of rounded pebbles. For classification of conglomerate, we basically considered the three types. These are, first of all, the epiclastic conglomerate or extra-formational conglomerate. In this conglomerate, the clasts which are derived from the different basins rather than a single basin. It means that it is composed of a heterogeneous clast. In this intra-formational conglomerate, the clast is derived from the same basin rather than multiple basins. And in agglomeratic conglomerate, these clasts are consolidated pyroclastics, which are ejected from a volcano or any volcanic activities, and all the products which are from the volcano, which gets consolidated while they are flying or while they are just falling nearby the volcano, they all are considered under the agglomeratic conglomerate. For the classification of epiclastic or extra-formational conglomerate, there are two types of conglomerate under this. One is orthoconglomerate and second one is paraconglomerate. Orthoconglomerate means this type of conglomerate having matrix less than 15%. Means it is consist of a matrix which is less than 50%, and detritals are closely packed. And the most important thing is that it is having a very good sphericity, roundness, and it indicates the stable tectonic setting. So for the demarcation of stable tectonic setting, we consider all these orthoconglomerates which is having a well-rounded pebbles. On the other hand, paraconglomerate, it consists of matrix of around or equal to 15%, and all the grains or the clasts are ill-sorted or unsorted. By the way, they are polymodal in size, and basically we call this paraconglomerate as an immature conglomerate. So it indicates unstable tectonic setting or unstable tectonic environment, for example glacial till or tillite, as when glacial recedes, it just leaves its larger bowlers clasts, and all those clasts later gets combined, clumped, and they will form a paraconglomerate. A very good example is dimictites, and under this there is a tillites and tilloids. All these are considered. So under the category of extra-formational conglomerate, there are basically two conglomerates, that is orthoconglomerate and paraconglomerate. Again, I am saying orthoconglomerate is less than 15% matrix content, and on the other hand, paraconglomerate is having roughly equal to 15% matrix content. So these two are the major categories. Further, this orthoconglomerate is divided into two, that is oligomictic conglomerate and paramictic or polymictic conglomerate, that is polymictic conglomerate. So in oligomictic conglomerate, they always mark the basal Cambrian. This is famous for basal Cambrian successions. In this conglomerate, all the clasts are of same composition, while in polymictic conglomerate, the clasts having different composition, different chemical composition. This indicates that the pebbles, the clasts which are derived from the different sources, or in oligomictic conglomerate, all these clasts are derived from the same rock, or maybe the same rock which indicate a constant chemical composition or a similar chemical composition. So on this basis, the orthoconglomerate is divided into oligomictic conglomerate and polymictic conglomerate. So again, I am just describing the classification of extra-formational conglomerate, that is epiclastic conglomerate, in which clast has been derived from the multiple basin, and it is being divided into two, orthoconglomerate and paraconglomerate, on the basis of matrix content, the tectonic setting, whether it is stable or unstable, and the most important is the roundness or the matrix and clast content of this conglomerate. And again, this orthoconglomerate is derived whether the clasts are of same chemical composition or similar composition, or whether they are of of a different chemical composition. So on this basis, they are derived, they are classified into oligomictic conglomerate and polymictic conglomerate. The another classification, or another the second terminology in the conglomeratic classification, is intraformational conglomerate. These are indicative of minor oscillation in basin or local folding or faulting. And so this, in this intraformational conglomerate, all the class are derived from within the same basin. As well, in this category, all the class has been derived from the different basins, or they are must transported, while in this conglomerate they are derived from the same basin. While again, the question in agglomerative conglomerate, the class are already the material which are ejected from a volcano. So in this way, this whole conglomeratic classification is given out. Thank you.